Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of CodeIgniter on Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily create a simple CodeIgniter project and how to run that on our browser. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee this video is going to be very interesting. And if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in the middle, you can always comment me on our comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now. So you can always ask me on Instagram by sending all of your doubts with screenshots and everything. I'm definitely going to help you. Now to install CodeIgniter, you will basically need three things. One is PHP. Next, you will need a text editor, which will be Visual Studio Code, which is what I am going to use on this video. You can use any text editor. I'll be using Visual Studio Code. And the third thing that you'll need is a composer. So PHP Composer is basically a package manager of PHP, and I'll be showing how to use this PHP Composer on installing or how to create a CodeIgniter project using this composer. So now let's go to your favorite browser and download all the softwares first. Let's just simply type Visual Studio Code. Hit enter and you'll see this link. Just go inside that official site of Visual Studio Code and click on download for Windows. So thanks for your download. Our Visual Studio Code will get rightly started downloading. Next thing is what you'll need is Composer. So Composer download. You'll see this getcomposer.org. Just go inside that folder. And again, this link and the Visual Studio Code link, I'm going to provide right in your description. So once you are here to this composer, you will see this composer setup.exe over here. You need to click on this link and immediately you will see that our composer is also downloaded over here. Right. So you'll need these two things, and the third thing that you will need is PHP. So for that I have used VAM server. So in my previous videos, I have showed you how to install VAM server. So you can use that, you can watch that video to install VAM server, and you can use that PHP that VAM server is using, right? So you know, when you have these three software, just go to your download directory. So we have Visual Studio Code and Composer. Just install it one by one, accept the license agreement, go next, check all the check boxes, next, install. So our Visual Studio Code is rightly started installing, and it has rightly installed. So click on finish. So it will also launch our Visual Studio Code. So in my previous videos, I showed you how to install Laravel. So that project is opened over here. If you want, you can also watch my previous video to know how to install Laravel or how to create a Laravel project. For now, let's close this. So next, you need to install Composer. So again, before installing Composer, it is very important to install PHP first. So if you go to the C drive, you will see I already have XAMPP and VAMP. All those softwares are already installed. You can install any software. You can install VAMP or XAMPP, whichever you like. All right. So if you go inside that XAMPP folder, you will see a PHP folder. So this path is what you need to point to Composer. So if you're using XAMPP, then you need to point to this folder. Or if you are using VAMP, in that case, you need to go inside this bin folder and you need to go inside this PHP folder, and then you need to select one PHP version. I'm going to select the latest one, and this folder path is what we need to point on Composer, right? So how to point? I'm going to show you that now. So again, just double click on the Composer installation setup. Click on install for users. It will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. And under installation options, you need to click on next. So here is the point that I was talking about. So if you, you know, click on this drop down, you will see all these different exes that are available on your system. So I have both this VAMP and XAMPP. So within that VAMP and XAMPP, we have php.exe folder. So that path is, it is pointing and it is showing it over here. So you can select any php.exe you want. You can select XAMPP also, or you can select VAMP, any of the PHP from here. I'm going to select the latest one from VAMP. which is 8.3.6. So I'm going to select this one and I'm going to click on next, and it's going to start installing our composer. Just click on install and there you go. You can see it is directly installed. So click on next, finish. So our composer is directly installed now. Now it's time to create a CodeIgniter project. Just right click and let's create a new folder, and let's name this folder as CodeIgniter dash workspace, and let's go inside that folder. And here what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this path and I'm going to type cmd to open our command prompt. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create, you know, a CodeIgniter project that's going to reside inside CodeIgniter workspace folder. So that's why I have opened this command prompt right at this directory. And now to create a CodeIgniter project, you need to run one script. So for that, let's go to browser and let's look for a CodeIgniter documentation. So just type CodeIgniter and hit enter. So latest version of CodeIgniter is 4.5.5 at the time of making of this video. So that is what I'm going to install. If you are watching this video much later, you might see a different versions. Alright, so you need to click on installation. So here you will see a detailed, you know, documentation for all these different versions. I'll select this composer installation and I'll scroll down, and here you will see this script. See, composer space create project, then CodeIgniter 4, app starter, and then we have a project name which is project root. Just, you know, simply select this script and let's go to this CodeIgniter workspace directory that we have created and right click and paste that script over here and hit enter, and immediately we'll see that it is rightly started creating our project. So it is rightly started fetching all the files from internet and then it's going to install it locally on our system. So you need to have active internet connection right throughout this installation. So all these files is going to fetch and going to install it. It's going to take some time, a couple of minutes maybe. So by the time it get installed, I'll request you, please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos. So if you subscribe this channel and if you subscribe Geeky Script blogging channel, that's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. So do subscribe our channel, and also you can follow me on our Instagram. I'm definitely going to ask and clear all of your doubts. So here you can see that our CodeIgniter is rightly installed. So our project is rightly created. So if you, you know, move this, you'll see that our project root folder is rightly created within CodeIgniter workspace folder. So our project is rightly created. Let's go inside that folder. So just simply type cd, then project dash root and hit enter. So you'll be inside your project root directory now. And here if you just simply type code space dot and hit enter, you'll see that our, you know, Visual Studio Code is rightly opened by opening this project root folder, which is a CodeIgniter folder. So you can always click on this I trust the authors and all, and you can always expand this app and you'll see all of your project structures that are lying over here. You will see this controller. If you expand this, you will see, you know, base controller.php along with home.php. You can always expand these views. There you'll see this welcome message.php. So this is our style tag, and if you scroll down, you know, below, you will see header, body tag, all of these already, you know, that are already written by default within our project, right? So now it's time to run our CodeIgniter project that you have created. So for that, you need to go to terminal and click on new terminal. So that's going to open our terminal over here. So within our, you know, CodeIgniter workspace, then project root folder, that project that you have created, our terminal is rightly open. Here you need to type php spark serve, that's all, and hit enter. So immediately we'll see, it will show that CodeIgniter command line tool, serve time and everything, and here you will have the link. So you need to, you know, click on control, you need to basically press the control key on your keyboard and click on this localhost 8080, and immediately we'll see that it is up and running, right? So our CodeIgniter is properly running on our localhost 8080 port. And whatever you're getting over here, that is basically coming from this welcome message.php. So if you are removing anything from here, so I'll remove till here everything that are there within body tag, and I'll just simply give a p tag, and within p tag I'll just simply type hello world, and I'll end the tag, and I'll just save this file. Just go to file and click on save. And now if I go to browser and just simply click on refresh, you can see that everything is completely wiped out and it is only showing hello world, whatever we have written on our this welcome message.php file, right? So whatever thing you are writing on this file, so that going to render on your browser and you can start working on your CodeIgniter projects. So that's how you install CodeIgniter on a Windows operating system. I have also installed Visual Studio Code along with Composer, and I have showed you how to create a CodeIgniter project on this video itself. So if these videos are really helping you, do consider subscribing our channel along with Geeky Syntax, along with Geeky Script blogging channel. That's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. And also on this channel, you'll get a lot of videos on WordPress, how to create a e-commerce store for completely free. So all these videos you'll also get on this channel. So you can also watch all those videos on this channel. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.